Thank you, Larry. It's the NFL on EA Sports as you take a look live there at Lincoln Financial Field in Philadelphia, PA. The scene in South Philly a few moments ago. Boy, the city of brotherly love is fired up. They're saying fly, Eagles, fly as they get ready to match up. Solid return, pretty good field position. They'll start at the 32-yard line with the Minnesota Vikings. Foles. And his first look is incomplete.
It's a lot of contact going on there. And in the end, unable to keep two hands on the football and bring it into his body.
Everything looked pretty good until the finish. State alum, Jay Ajayi. And he will lose yardage here to the 31-yard line. It'll be a loss of one, and that's going to lead to a third and 11.
Anthony Barr got a real education at UCLA in playing not just his normal position of stand-up outside linebacker, but down defensive end. So he had to incorporate a variety of moves, take on bigger people. So he learned great leverage while he was there. That really helps him when he's trying to stop people running the ball.
Born in South Bend, Indiana. Thought about going back to go to Notre Dame, but you're right, great career at UCLA. And got his man complete. And he's taken down, but not before he gets this into enemy territory across the 40. A big 30-yard play on third. So after that big gain, let's see what else the offense has up its sleeve. Now Foles. Now he's going to send this one deep right, and he'll take it into the end zone for an Eagles touchdown. Jay Ajayi, 39 yards, and the Eagles have taken the early lead. Didn't have anything downfield, swung it out to the flat, he did the rest.
Such a staple of so many offenses we see now. You know, in our discussions with offense coordinators, how many times do they tell us, hey, this offense is designed for either a touchdown or a check down. We saw the check down on that play, and boy, was it successful.
We saw a touchdown, too. Elliott now to kick this one away. To return, here comes Marcus Sherrills. Spins by. Oh, and now he bowls him over. And he'll take this one near the 25, call it the 26-yard line. And now out comes Minnesota. Here is going to fall incomplete. He was looking for Adam Thielen there, and that'll bring up second down. Charles already trailing by a touchdown early. This offense, how imperative is it for them to get points out of this drive?
Well, they feel like they have to go ahead and match because of what was already on the board against their defense. But I think even more so, you just want to avoid three and outs. You want to be able to stay on the field for a little while, let your defense catch their breath a little bit, even if you don't score any points.
Now it's Keenum. And a flag comes in as that one falls incomplete. Well, let's see who this is on. So flag for the contact, pass interference.
And I know that you're going to look at me and roll your eyes, and rightfully so, because you know what I'm going to say. Doesn't the defender have a right to the football as well?
No, I don't like defenders.
That's because you spent too much time with me. Okay, I'll side with you on this one. This is the correct call.
Now a first carry for Latavius Murray. He'll get only a couple down to the 44.
That's a good play by the guys on the defensive side of the ball. Held him to a gain of 2. And that changes the playbook a little bit now for the guy calling plays. 2nd and 8. Now he's got to probably think about going to the air instead of maybe staying with the ground game.
Let's see what the offense comes with here. 2nd and 8. They go with Murray again. And he'll lose yardage here. Back at the 47. They'll wind up losing 3. And now it's 3rd down.
Every year I go to the combine, I marvel at the speeds that linebackers are running nowadays. They run like DBs. And let's face it, they know how to finish plays too. Eyes up, head up, run right through them.
Play action, it's Keenum. And that is incomplete.
Let's face it, perfection is something we all chase, whether it's playing this game or whatever we do. Hard to attain, but that's what they were searching for as that pass goes incomplete.
So on 4th down, here's Ryan Quigley now to kick this one away. And this one will not be returnable as it sails out of bounds. Philadelphia getting sent to take the field. They'll be looking to duplicate the effort to drive number 1 that resulted in 7 points in the 7-zip lead.
Well, you know how much I enjoy horse racing, right? Looks like they caught a flyer out of the gate, as they would say when you're running the big-time races. It means they get out to a fast start. They're setting the pace, making the other team chase now.
Begin the drive with Ajayi. They'll only get a couple up to about the 30. For Ajayi, he's had 7 games so far this year with the Eagles. How key is he going to be with Nick Foles, the quarterback, instead of Carson Wentz in this playoff push?
He'll be a monster key in this one, and he'll be part of what I think is going to be a 3-headed monster that they'll use in the run, in the backfield in the playoffs. Jay Ajayi, he's going to be the sprinter-type guy, can create the big plays. LeGarrette Blount, he's that guy just moves the ball between the guards and the tackles. And Corey Clement, he's kind of a do-it-all type of a player, an undrafted free agent out of Wisconsin. But Ajayi, if he can get a few big sprints in and open things up for his offense, yeah, he could be the guy that could carry them deep in the playoffs. Someone sharp in this game. I mean, a touchdown pass on the first drive and comes right back, and he's flinging it around really well here.
Really nice throw there to pick up the first down. You kind of just feel a laser focus and confidence about him, and I think we saw that this week, didn't we? Talking to him and the coaches, they felt good about his performance coming up.
Yeah, I was really impressed with that last practice we saw when they went through 2-minute drill, when they went through all the different situations. Ball hardly hit the ground, and I thought, yeah, he might be locked in for this one.
We haven't seen much from him running the football here in this first quarter.
No, you're right about that. We haven't seen much of him at all so far. They've stacked him up pretty well. But when you're trying to run the football, sometimes you got to play the long game. Keep handing it to him, and some of those runs that aren't working now, they turn into 6, 7, 8, and maybe more later on.
There's Foles. And incomplete. Torrey Smith, the intended receiver. And that takes us from 2nd to 3rd down.
Well, they're slinging it. And then there's one you got to put a timer on, huh? I mean, that one came in hot.
That came in hot, but overthrown, out of his reach and incomplete. And the Vikings with an extra defender in the secondary on 3rd.
Playing coverage here.
He'll drop to throw. And incomplete. The contact made the ball roam free and brings up 4th down. So possession 1 ended in 6. Possession 2 likely going to end in a punt.
Yeah, that's okay. They've just got to get back to what they worked on in the opening drive and continue to make a few adjustments along the way. It won't be exact because the defense will make a few adjustments themselves. Just get back to your game plan.
And the kick's away as he angles this one for the sideline. This one will sail out of bounds. It'll depend on the spot here. And the side judge says that went out at the 7-yard line. Now the Vikings offense works their way back onto the field.
They're going to have to go at least 50, 60 yards here if they want to ensure that they don't have to punt the ball like they did last time.
Yeah, so what you're saying is we're not playing to just get out of the shadow of your own goal line, right? You're playing to make sure the punter doesn't see the field again. So it's not picking up a couple of first downs. You want to pick up 5 or 6 first downs and make sure you move the ball into their territory.
It's complete to Laquon Treadwell. And they're going to have this one up near the 30-yard line. A good pickup there, a 22. So there on that play, offensively, they ran the crossing route. Defense was in zone coverage. So as a former DB, how tough is it to defend that?
It's really difficult because your natural inclination is to chase the receiver and maybe leave your zone. So you have to have discipline in order to talk to your other coverage guys and let them know that that receiver's crossing from your zone to the next zone. He's coming your way. Make sure you have him. And then when the ball is actually thrown, secure the tackle. When they're moving on crossing routes, if you miss a tackle, it usually results in a big play.
That's not only Adam Thielen, that's the Pro Bowler Adam Thielen, who had 91 catches this year and over 1,200 yards, a career high.
We always look for great stories when we do games. Is there a better one this season than Adam Thielen in terms of where he came from to make a Pro Bowl roster as a receiver for the Minnesota Vikings? Lightly recruited out of high school, ends up at Mankato State, which is now known as Minnesota State Mankato. Undrafted, goes to a rookie free agent tryout camp, hangs around, makes the practice squad. First, he's a special teams guy, and now he's one of the better receivers in the league. I think it's one of the best stories I've heard in 2017 NFL.
Here's Keenum now on second down. Trying for right, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Rodney McLeod. 20, 10, 5. And he takes this one back into the end zone. And the Eagles defense gets a pick 6 TD. And this defense looking like they have come to play the pick 6. And just like that, it's 13-0 early on.
Well, go back with me to our training camp visits. What do we hear during these drills?
Oh. Pass.
Ball. Ball's in the air.
And then my favorite.
Oski. That's the interception. That means everybody find someone to block. Block them legally. Stay on your feet. And they get it done. Touchdown.
So they'll get another shot on offense following that pick 6. And now the kick is away. This is fielded a couple yards deep. And the decision to bring it out, a good one, as he's up a yard or two shy of the 30. The Vikings offense now, they get ready to head back on the field. And last time, decent field position through the pick 6. Obviously costly.
But they can't afford to just bunker in now. All right, good field position means go ahead and attack on offense. Try and press the advantage a little bit. They just have to be better with the football on this possession.
So the last, that didn't bother you too much last time.
No, because it's exactly what you're supposed to do. You can't have good field position, not try to take advantage of it. Sometimes the defense makes a good play too.
And not gonna be able to push this forward. He runs into a wall right at the line of scrimmage. No gain on the play, it'll be second down.
No gain on that run, and while the team is down, there's still time to come back and win the football game. If I'm the offensive coordinator, though, I've got to think about moving at a faster pace and maybe opening things up a little bit and throwing it a little bit more.
Let's go! 3-19!
Now Keenum throwing on second. And the hit jarred it loose. It's incomplete.
That was very well timed there defensively, because it's not a bad throw, but the collision came at the exact time he was reaching to bring in the football. Really, really well done.
Decent offense, just better defense. I think you're right.
Yeah, the Eagles will go with an extra DB here as they prepare for a stop on third.
Thinking pass all the way.
Working from the gun, Keenum. Pressure comes and down he goes. The Eagles get there for the sack. Fletcher Cox.
coming in to drop him for a loss of 8, and it'll be fourth down. Here's Ryan Quigley now. As the drive goes backwards, so he's on to punt it away. Fielded at the 20. And when it's said and done, it's a 58-yard punt. And the Eagles will have it, taking over first and 10. Philadelphia getting set to take the field. They're out in front. Last time they had to punt it away. We'll see if they can add to their lead now.
They don't want to go out and punt it away again. This team now wants to get a cushion, put people away. They want to run their offense and have it end up in the end zone.
They'll start out on the ground with a giant. And he'll be tackled at about the 35. 5 yards on the carry. Good pickup on first down.
Frustrating for a defense, energizing for an offense. Finding a way to create that type of yardage in your running game, that'll make the guys carrying the ball very, very happy.
And after the play on the ground, that brings up second down here. He'll look to throw. They set up the screen to Ajayi. And a big collision there as he winds up flat on his back. 8 yards on the pickup there, and it moves the sticks. And just in general, Charles, on a play like that, how tough is it for the defense to account for a running back essentially being a receiver downfield?
It's very difficult, especially if the running back has skills like a receiver, and you're aware of that before the game even begins. So throughout your practice sessions, you're going to want to be aware of him. Where is he lining up? What can he do? What kind of damage can he do to us downfield? And who can match up with him without weakening our overall defense? You're exactly right. It's a tough task to match up to him.
So he can't hang on, and as I watch that unfold, I remembered an expression that I've heard, maybe from you, I don't know, but you're going to get hit anyways, might as well hold on to the ball.
Right, you know a coach said that, right? Yeah. Not an actual player? Not a chance at all. Way easier said than done.
And second and 10, he'll look to throw again. He's going to flip that out to the flat. It's complete. And he'll get it out to midfield. Let's say, yeah, they'll spot it right at midfield at the 50. Give him 6 on the play, and that'll make it third down.
I know most of the time when the ball's in the air, you're thinking wide receiver, tight end, but running backs, they can be a big part of any passing offense nowadays.
So still in search of the first down after that last completion. They'll run it now out of the gun, and he gets this one across midfield for the first down to the 46. It's a gain of 4 there, and it gives him a new set of downs.
On third down, that's a good job of situational football and understanding where the first down marker was and getting there.
Offense comes to the line now, first and 10. They go play action here on first down. Over the middle, complete. That's Burton. And he gets it inside the 35 and just shy of the 30. 15 yards through the air and a first down.
That throw has to be a quarterback's dream, doesn't it? Big tight end curling in the middle of the field, so it's great sight lines for him. And when they show their numbers back to the quarterback, when they sit down right there, that should be pitch and catch.
They'll run it now out of the gun, and he'll get about 3 as he's brought down to the 28. Back live with Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gordon. It's the Eagles with the ball here to begin quarter number 2. They face a 2nd and 7 to start things out. On play action, they'll throw. Under a heavy rush, and down he goes. Tom Johnson getting in there from his defensive tackle spot to snow him under for a loss of 4. Well, they go play fake. The problem is nobody was faked out.
And when no one's faked out, what's the end result? Sack. Quarterback gets hit.
The Eagles on third down. They've been okay. 2 for 3 thus far. This is third down and 12.
Back 22.
Back to throw here. And this is going to be incomplete.
Sometimes the coverage is so good, no matter what you're doing on offense, you just can't shake anyone free. They try their best to find someone open, but they took away every passing alley, every angle, and shut the play down.
Now Jake Elliott for the field goal try. This is a 49-yard attempt, right hash. And this is just outside the right upright. It's no good, and this score will stay right where it is.
Well, this winds up an empty possession. Everything looked okay. He just never got the ball on target. And knowing him, he'll be disappointed with that effort.
After the missed kick, they're in really good position. They'll begin this drive at the 39 now.
Let's go! Green, 39!
Keenum on first down. Over the middle here to Rudolph. And he'll be taken down at the 46-yard line. 7 yards, the pickup on the pitch and catch.
Now that's staying ahead of the chains. Really good pickup on first down, hitting the tight end there. Now it brings up a second and manageable.
Just found a hole in that zone.
Hurry up, here we go. Green, 39.
That was second down run for Murray. And no room to maneuver there. Give him a yard up to the 47.
When the 4-3 defense is functioning really well, you know who stays what we call clean and no one gets to him? The guy playing the middle linebacker position, the guy we call Mike. That means the defensive front has eaten up all the blocks and just let him go to the football and make a play.
They'll run here. It's Murray. And he's got the first down yardage as he takes it down to the 49. A gain of 4 that time as the drive continues.
And we tend to give those running backs that are slashers a lot of credit, but how about guys who are maulers? Because that's what you want in short yardage situations, and we just saw that occur right there, didn't we?
Vertical, downhill running. On first down, Murray. Murray, strong running, and he's brought down. Give him 11 yards that time and a new set of downs.
You and I both know that you don't really truly replace Adrian Peterson, but Latavius Murray's a really good back. Similar running styles, too. Won't wear the same number, we know that. But when you see him run, you might see a little bit of that in him, upright with some power.
Now a give. This is Murray. And he'll get 3 down to the 34-yard line.
So many times we look at a short run and we praise the offense for trying to set the tempo and establish things, but the defensive guys, hey, they just won the battle there. It wasn't a big run given up. They don't always have to absorb the body blows. Sometimes they dish them out themselves.
Now the Georgia Southern man, this is Jerick McKinnon. Trying to run inside, but nothing there. No gain on the play there, so they're left with a 3rd down and 6.
While there was no gain on that run, we do know coaches whose identity is rooted in taking it almost to the limit and then changing things up on you down the stretch. I think we're getting really close to that point in time, though, where the identity may have to go out the window. They've got to go a little bit faster in order to try and win the game.
Throwing on 3rd down, Keenum. Looking left side, he's got it, complete. And he works it to the 30-yard line here, right at the 30. They get only 4 that time as that leads us to a 4th down.
They didn't get the 1st down, but I have to say I do like the call. I like what they were trying to do. Try and hit your receiver on the run and see if he can pick it up. Keep it on his feet, get a little rack yardage.
Yeah, but a nice job defensively to get to him and keep him short of the first. And Forbath will put this one through, and they will get themselves on the board here at 14-3. So it goes down as an 8-play drive, and they cap it with the field goal.
Yeah, they were able to pick up a few 1st downs along the way, but they couldn't keep the momentum going all the way into the end zone.
Horvath now to kick it away after the made field goal. This fielded at the two. And a nice return sets him up pretty good here at the 30-yard line. The Eagles offense now gets set to head back onto the field. Now they had compiled a pretty long drive last time. Unfortunately, though, it ended with no points after the missed field goal.
And that can hurt the psyche of a team, because as they drove downfield, you know you're never supposed to count points in your mind until they go up on the board. But let's face it, we've been there. We've seen teams before. They were counting on those points. They didn't get them. Can they come back now, start over again, and grind it out?
He's going to air one out. Chip, that's caught inside the 20. And he is down deep into Minnesota territory. A big play there for Philly. 56 yards. Zone now. They'll look to throw. That's going to be caught at the 10-yard line. And now they're inside the 10 as he's brought down at the 9. 5 yards on the catch there. Brings up second down. And that's one of his advantages of a passer, is it not? With his height, setting back there in the pocket, firing it over the middle, he can really see everything clearly.
It is, and I know that other quarterbacks get it done different ways, all right? You don't have to be his height to make a great play. But what he does is he takes away having to make those slide steps in the pocket.
And no escaping this time as he'll go down. They got him for a sack. Linval Joseph getting in there from his defensive tackle spot to snow him under for a loss of 4. In need of a conversion on third down. They had the big play to start the drive. Not much since. The play fake. He'll look to throw. Got a man open. It's Ertz. Touchdown, Philadelphia. Zach Ertz from 13 yards out. And the Eagles had 6 to their lead. Yeah, he is a reliable target. They like to get him involved. They got him involved there for the score.
And they should. He's a very good player. Remember, they can use him in certain positions, so many different spots, and he usually comes through for them.
And it's up and good. Elliott now to kick this one away. Fielded about a yard deep. And he'll wind up getting an extra couple yards here for his trouble as he'll bring this one out to the 27. And now out comes Minnesota. And tough to win games if you're going field goal, field goal, field goal here. They got field goal last time. Now they'll be looking for a touchdown.
They're looking for the big chunk now because, as you noted, the field goal, field goal, field goal way of doing it makes it that much harder and puts more pressure on every possession for you now. Go ahead and get 6 and feel a lot more comfortable about the position they're in.
Bigger chunks. We'll see if they can get the score. They begin the drive with a run by Murray. And they will stop him after a fairly minimal pickup. 2 yards on the carry there. It'll be second down.
I think if they want to start getting back into this game, it behooves them to get better on first down.
Yeah, certainly not what they were looking for there out of the opening play of this drive. On second down, here's Keenum. He's going to float this one deep right side. And he's unable to grab it. Thought he might have had position, couldn't hold on, third down.
And attempted a deep ball there. They didn't get it. But, boy, they're going to need a few of those to actually hit in order to get back into this game.
Good thing they do have a little bit of time here still left in the contest. Decent-sized deficit, but not one that they can't manage.
All right, here we go. Boom,
throwing is Keenum on third down. He finds McKinnon complete. And he'll be brought down right around the 37. 7 yards on the play, and it'll be fourth down.
So many times you hear today's NFL described as a space game. Get your best players into space with the football in their hands. That's why sometimes you swing it out to your runner, get him out in the flat, and let him have a chance to make people miss an open field.
Here comes the pressure, and the Eagles get there to block it. The Eagles offense now, they head back on the field. Well, we say it all the time, offense, defense, don't forget about special teams. Big punt block there.
And how many coaches have told us if we make a big play on special teams, if we find a way to score, whether it's on the play or later, 90%+ of the time, we win the game.
Just don't hold them to those numbers.
No, we haven't quantified it yet, but they believe it, and we have seen it happen many, many times in just that manner. We use the word relentless a lot with guys who are aggressive on the field. In this case, it really fits, doesn't it? How about his ability to break tackles and his feet never stop moving?
Out of the gun, they'll look to throw. Now the pressure gets there and he goes down just inside the 20 at the 19. Tom Johnson in there to get him for his second sack of the night.
Well, that was point counterpoint, wasn't it? They decide to throw for it on first and goal. Instead, the defense counters with pressure, and the defense wins, getting a big sack.
Shotgun. He'll look to throw. Yeah, he finds his tight end. It's Ertz. And they'll bring him down at the 13-yard line. 5 yards that time on the completion. And now it's third and goal. Not a big window to throw. Coverage wasn't too bad there.
Yeah, they had him under wraps pretty well, but somehow able to muscle his way open and catch the ball.
Well, definitely be a disappointment to come out of this starting position with just 3 points. They need to try to dial something up now, third and 10. They're going to look to throw. Throwing for his running back, and he's got him complete. And now the Vikings are going to stop it here on defense with a timeout. It's just their first, so they'll have 2 remaining here before we get to halftime. And for the second time tonight, this field goal unit comes out here. From the right hash, and this one just a chippy. And a kick by Elliott is good. And that will stretch the lead up to 3 touchdowns now. It's a 21-point game. So a good kick that time, and he's able to redeem himself from the previous miss.
And fortunately for him, he got the chance to do that not long after missing the first time. Sometimes a whole game goes by, and you don't get that chance at all. So you keep it with you till the next time you take the field.
After the field goal, here's Elliott to kick it away. This will be taken in at the 1. Now the Vikings offense gets set to take over here. First down, it's Keenum. And his throw's going to be incomplete. He was looking for his tight end there, Kyle Rudolph. And now it's second down.
Well, hey, that gives us a second here to sneak into discussion about fantasy football players who won championships, giving back maybe to the players that helped them win that championship. So Todd Gurley has a great week, 15 and 16, and it started where people are actually donating money to Todd Gurley's charity, and over 10 grand has gone to his Shriners charity.
Yeah, I think it's a fantastic concept, and wherever it came from, a lot of it is just in the spirit of helping others, you know? So, hey, I won my league. This player did this to help me. Let me donate to his charity of choice, help some others who can't help themselves. It did not hurt that this really sprang up around the holiday season, mm-hmm. You know, that spirit of giving. And now a lot of players who help contribute to people winning championships, I think they'll see a little bit extra in their charity causes kitty when the whole thing is done.
So the offense readies for a second and four. From the 50, it's Keenum. And this one hauled in by Rudolph. And they're able to get this one down to the 25. That one goes for 24 yards.
His position, and he's listed as a tight end, but he certainly doesn't run like one, and that's what we're seeing more and more coming into the league, those guys who can run, make plays after the catch, and gain that additional yardage.
And using that speed there to turn it into a pretty nice little game. Keenum now on first down. He's going to flip one out here to his running back. And he will score. Touchdown, Vikings. Latavius Murray, as the first half is winding down, and the Vikings are able to close the gap just a bit.
Well, that touchdown certainly helps, but they've got to go ahead and convert, get to the half, and figure out how to keep chopping down this lead in the second, don't they?
Yeah, they still need to regroup, and they still need to end the second quarter strong. A little bit of time left. Forbath out to kick this one away. On the return, it's Kenyon Barner. And he'll take it past the 25 and up to the 28-yard line. Now Philadelphia ready to get going on offense again. And from this spot in the field with the clock where it's at, you think we're just going to see a knee and that's it?
And I think in this situation, that's the proper play. But we do know there's some risk takers out there that may want to take one more shot before the clock runs out.
Here's a handoff to Ajayi to begin the drive. And not going to be able to push this forward. He runs into a wall right at the line of scrimmage. So we've come to halftime here in Philly with the Eagles on top as we send you down to Orlando where we check in with Larry Ridley and our EA Sports Halftime Report. Take it away, Larry. This is taken at his four. And it's a pretty good return here as he'll get it up to the 29-yard line. Out come the Vikings. They'll have it first on offense as we begin the third. They have the ball here for the inaugural drive of the second half. Pretty big deficit, though. We'll see what adjustments were made in that locker room.
And I never want to make something more important than it actually is, right? I don't want to create more hype than what is there.
But this
is
a
I'm doing it, though. This is a really important drive. And we often talk about teams scripting plays to start a game. A lot of them script to start the second half, too. And they're scripting something that they expect to get them into the end zone and back into this game.
We'll see if that script is a good one for them. And a nice carry there of 15 yards.
Well, last year, I'm not sure we saw very many of those runs, did we, from the Vikings? I mean, they had the poorest rushing attack in the league.
Just 75 yards per game, but
carries like the one we just saw, that'll help bolster that average.
Yeah, certainly. And they tried to beef up the offensive line in the offseason, brought in Latavius Murray, and then drafted Dalvin Cook out of Florida State.
They go back to Murray on first down. And taking it across midfield and inside the 45. They give him 14 yards that time and a fresh set of downs.
I'm okay with the call there. In fact, I actually like it. I know they're down a couple of scores, but the running game worked in that situation. I would continue to go in that direction.
They'll run it now out of the gun. And he'll lose yardage on the play back at the 45-yard line. A loss of a full 3 yards, and now it's second down.
It's real easy to say this running game needs to be better, but the reality is they've been given little time to actually find a place to run the football. It's almost like the defense is there on the handoff.
They'll run it now out of the gun. Try to find a lane, but instead he'll get back to the line of scrimmage and no more. Maybe a gain of a yard that time, but now from the spot, actually no gain. So third and long. The Vikings on third down, just 1 for 5 to this point. This is third down and 12.
Let's go, 3-19.
They'll fake the handoff. Now Keenum, and that is incomplete.
Let's face it, if you want to get back into the game, these are the kind of throws you got to hit. He's wide open right there. Got to be able to get it to him, don't you think?
And those are the throws that haven't been available to them every time he's dropped a pass. Yeah, that's a big miss. Here's Ryan Quigley now. Remember, though, he did have one blocked earlier. And he'll get this away into the icy winter air. And it's out of bounds. Now we'll see what the side judge says. He says out at the 8-yard line. Now we take a glance at the offense as they work their way back out for their first possession of the second half. This is sort of what you would call a put-away drive, isn't it? I mean, they score here, especially a touchdown. It's almost out of reach.
It certainly feels that way, and I think that they're going to call their plays accordingly, because what you really want to do, even though you know the scoreboard is still up there and the game's going to go on, in fact, you can take the spirit away from another team. Their drive and will to come back and win can be taken with another score right here.
Still third quarter, but you just get that feel.
Yeah, they're teetering right there on the brink, aren't they? Absolutely love the run right there. This guy's known for his quickness, but also for his speed. And he's able to get to the second level almost before you blink if you give him any type of blocking. Always talk about slot receivers, and they're usually known as quicker than fast. In this case, we've got a guy who's quick and fast, and he used it to great advantage.
They run again with Ajayi. He'll get about 3 as he's taken down at the 23.
Third quarter, and you've got the lead. You're not ready to go into that 4-minute offense to close the game out, but a running game can really benefit your team right now.
Now Foles. Hurts over the middle. And they'll bring him down at the 27-yard line. That catch good for 5. It's third down.
Let's not quibble about the gain there on second down. That was a positive play because that was a take-what-you-can-get situation. Got out to the tight end. Now it gives them a much better opportunity to convert on third down.
The Eagles on third down. They've hit it 50%, 3 of 6 to this point. Here it's 3rd and 2. They'll run it now out of the gun. And he gets it to the 34. Good enough for the first. 7 yards there. Good enough to move the sticks.
I don't know about you, but that almost felt like old-time football there. 3rd and 2 is not necessarily just a running down anymore. A lot of times they want to throw the ball. They went back to the roots and powered forward and got the first down.
Here's Foles. Ertz has it left side. A gain of 6 there on first.
When you execute a drag or a crossing route really well and give them a chance to let it develop a little bit, you can gain some significant yardage hitting your tight end on that one.
Second down and four. Looks like the defense in press coverage here. Here's Ajayi. And some room to run now. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. It's a gain of 11 yards that time, and it produces a new set of downs.
Now, this is an example of breaking down a defense, because on a lot of these runs, he's getting past the point of attack, and guess what he's doing? Forcing the secondary guys to have to make a lot of tackles.
Now a first carry for LeGarrette Blount. A decent run there following the display of quick feet down just inside the 45. He'll get a nice chunk there on the first down run, and it's second and four.
So under the category of, while it can't be us because we're not that good, but could you imagine if this was you? LeGarrette Blount, his first 1,000-yard season since, what, 2010, his rookie year, and 18 touchdowns in the regular season, and no longer with New England.
He is over 30 now. He turned 30 in December. I don't know if that played a factor, but, yeah, such a productive year, and then he's gone.
Well, that just tells you this. Now he's going to be playing with a chip on his shoulder trying to prove something.
It goes as a gain of eight, and it moves the chains. Great change up there on the route and got that inside release, made it a successful pitch and catch.
Well, the first thing you want to do is have him thinking that you're going outside. Make a move in that direction. Then you really don't run the route against the whole body of the defender. You run against a half of him in the inside half, and he took it right across his face, got inside, and won that route in a big way.
Drops it off to Ajayi. And this time, not quite to the 30. It'll be down at the 31-yard line. He's already proven to be a factor in the running game on this drive. Now he gets involved in the passing game.
I think what we're seeing here is the modern version of workhorse in the NFL, being able to run it and catch it with equal proficiency.
Foles. His throw incomplete. So the numbers have been good in the passing game, and certainly a big reason why they have the lead. But now here, third quarter, maybe go to the run game a little more?
Yeah, perhaps. I mean, after that incompletion, a little credit to the defense for shutting them down on that play. Maybe you try and run the football a little bit more in this spot, but they have to feel good about how they've been throwing it overall.
They'll drop the throw. Aguilar has it. And the broken tackle helps lead to a first down gain. He goes for 18 there as the drive will continue.
One thing I can say pretty safely, that route is not called if you don't have a guy who can throw the ball and put some mustard on it. Because if you're going to lollipop it in the middle of the field, bad things usually happen. It takes a strong-armed guy who can rifle it in there, and they were able to successfully complete that one.
And welcome back. We are in the city of brotherly love, Philadelphia. It's the Eagles in possession of the football and leading this one as we get ready to start the final quarter. He'll drop to throw. That is caught at the 7-yard line. And here he'll get it down to the 7. A gain of 6 there on first.
Another nice pickup through the air, and I think a lot of people might expect them to run the ball in this situation, Brandon, but with this lead, they're electing to throw the football. Swings, slants, quick outs, things that they consider safe.
He'll look to throw. Pass incomplete. Well, not to get too overcritical there because he knows what he's doing, but his shoulders looked a little off kilter there when he threw that.
I don't think you're being overly critical there. You're just analyzing it, and he gets those shoulders right. That pass will go from incomplete to complete.
The Eagles on third down. They've had good success, 5 for 8 to this point. This is third and four. He'll look to throw. And he couldn't hang on to it through the contact. Incomplete. Now they've got to be a little frustrated here to not complete that on third down after having such a long drive going.
Hey, you're talking about going over 70 yards on the drive. Yeah, did you say a little frustrated?
Very frustrated.
Yeah, I'm with you on that. I'm very frustrated. There's no doubt about it. They thought they were going to have a chance to cash in the end zone. Now it looks like it's likely a field goal attempt.
And Elliott puts this one through. and that'll push the lead up to 17. And you figure with that, this game's pretty well out of reach.
It would take a heck of a comeback at this point. Being three scores down, I think that's too much to ask with time winding down here in the fourth.
After the field goal, here's Elliott to kick it away. That'll be taken in the end zone. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. And now out comes Minnesota.
These guys had to punt their last possession, and that's become too familiar of a refrain. Too many of these drives just wound up going nowhere.
Well, you know how in baseball, when the pitcher gets a base hit and he's on base, they bring his jacket out to him to keep him warm? A lot of times the punter goes to the sideline, puts on sweatpants or a wrap over his leg to keep it warm. He might need a massage from the trainer right now from all the work he's getting.
On first and 10, here's Keenum. He couldn't quite hold it. Got hit. Ball pops out. Incomplete.
Another wayward pass. You know, things started out poorly in this game, and to be frank, they just really haven't gotten much better.
And all that does is embolden a secondary. They feel good about what's going on, and they just play better and better.
Here we go now.
Back to the air. Keenum on second down. And he'll be out of bounds across the 30-yard line. 6 yards is the pickup, and that'll lead to a third down.
One thing I think that's safe to say defensively, the tackling's been really good.
And because of that, it's been very, very hard for them to move the ball because you're not getting the benefits of run after catch. They're tackling them almost on the spot. That means they have to run extra plays, harder to move it.
From the gun on third down, Keenum. And he's able to find Diggs. And he will have first down yardage as he's brought down at the 41. A nice pick up there, 10 yards, and it'll move the sticks. So the offense has it first and 10. Keenum to throw again. He's going to air one out. And this is what here? Incomplete, they say. It looked like it was intercepted, but he apparently did not get the 2 feet down in bounds.
This defense was definitely alert to the possibility of the deep ball, and they were more than ready for it.
They've got the lead, fourth quarter. Maybe can expect more passes like that downfield.
Keenum again here on second and 10. He's going to leave this for his running back. It's complete. And to the 42-yard line here and brought down there. Just a 1 yard pickup on the play. And all of a sudden here, it's third down. Well, still in search of the first down after that last completion. Throwing on third down, Keenum. He's going to hit his man out of the backfield, complete. And he's going to get this down to the 35-yard line. 23 yards on the play. Fresh set of downs here. They'll run it now out of the gun. And he'll work his way inside the 30 now to the 28. 7 yards on the pickup there, and it'll leave him with a second and 3.
Not too many offenses want to turn down long drives, but when you're down what they are, they've got to pay it off with some points.
3 yards to go on second down. Working from the gun, Keenum. And had too much juice. It'll be out of bounds, incomplete. Stephon Diggs, his intended receiver, and it's third and short. They have not gotten him going at all. Tried to spark something there with a longer throw, unable to complete it.
But you have to keep trying. He's one of their best playmakers. No matter what it says on the scoreboard, you're always trying to get him the football.
So 2 of 2 on third down conversions on this drive, and now they face a 3rd and 3 here. They'll run it now out of the gun. And he gets the first down here as he's taken down at the 24. Just 4 yards on the pickup, but that's good enough to extend the drive.
We all love to have a home run hitter in the backfield. Guy can take it the distance. But a short yardage, trying to pick up first downs, that big guy, always a nice luxury to have, isn't he?
Hurry up, here we go. Hey, 19.
Now we've got movement up front. And I think this is going to be on Minnesota. First and 15 here behind the chains.
Hey, tight end right. One tight end. Let's go.
Shotgun snap for Keenum. And complete. Right side, the tight end Rudolph. And he'll get it down this time to the 17. A good pickup after the penalty. 12 yards, and it's second down.
That coach is always harp on the quarterback reading the defense and getting it to the open man. That's good recognition there. And how about what he did after the catch?
Yeah, hit your tight end. Let him get some rack.
Yeah, but when he gets moving, not many guys want to come over and put a hit on him, do they?
They run again with Murray. He's seen a ton of action tonight. And he'll get about 3 as he's taken down at the 14-yard line.
You know that old expression, it's not my night. It hasn't been his so far. I don't know if the legs are a little bit heavy. Sometimes having to hang out all day and play doesn't exactly play to your advantage, but it's been a tough go for him.
And every time he looks up, somebody's there defensively. That was the same case on that play.
Green 39! Green 39!
Keenum on third down. Screen play, McKinnon. And he will have the first down inside the 10 to the 9-yard line. The gain of 5 that time gives him the conversion and makes it 1st and goal. Ooh, long drive. The defense just cannot seem to catch a break and get off the field. And now whistles here and a flag down. Looked like someone got going a little early. Looking to jam the receivers at the line here. Press coverage, look defensively.
Set. Green 39.
Now Keenum. And it pops free. The collision there jarred the ball loose and brings up 2nd down.
That would have been a great catch, but it's real difficult to hold on to it because it was contested all the way. Would have been a great play if he'd been able to haul that one in.
Second and goal to go now. Back to the ground game. Here's Murray. And they get to him quickly here as he stopped right around the 13. Only a yard there, and that'll bring us to 3rd and goal. They gotta have 6 here. It's 3rd and goal. Just play after play after play on this long drive for the offense. On 3rd and long, it's Keenum. And oh, it'll be intercepted. picked off by Jalen Mills. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back.
Well, this defensive pressure has been constant all game long. The pass rush, the coverage, they've all been excellent, and now they'll tack on an interception here as this one continues to slip just further and further out of hand.
Just a yard on the pickup there, and it'll bring up a 2nd and 9.
I like a guy who understands the situation. I also like a guy who you look at him and you say, that looks like a guy who knows the coach is going to say, guess what? You drop this one, you'll be carrying around a training facility for an entire week.
Maybe flashback to high school or college, carrying it around campus, right?
The old gauntlet drill, right? Anyone get the ball out while he's sitting in class and bring it back to the coach? He's in big trouble.
And he'll get this up only to about the 22. He only got a couple on that one, so not a ton of help. They'll have a 3rd and 8 forthcoming.
I like that run right there, partner. Not the flashiest run, not the one that's going to break for big yardage, but he understands the situation, and taking care of the football, paramount, and he got it done.
Nursing that slim lead, you're exactly right. Hold on to that ball. Looking to throw. And able to catch it on the left sideline, but they're going to rule him out of bounds. So it'll be incomplete, certainly one they'd like to have back as it brings up 4th down. Here's Donnie Jones now, as he'll kick it away for the 2nd time. His first punt, 45 yards. This looks good as well. A 47-yard punt, maybe a couple on the return. And control of the football, switching hands here with very little time remaining in this contest. Second down play, we'll get a whistle, a signal, and a timeout as they get it with 16 seconds remaining on the clock. Now the Minnesota offense set to take over again. They're down big here late. I don't know, you just one last drive here for pride?
Some people like to do that. I remember playing for a guy once, we were down huge, and someone said, Coach, what do you want to call? He just waved a hand like, who cares? Let's get out of here and do something some other time. But some teams like to do something at the end to feel a little bit better as they continue to move forward.
Yeah, probably just want to put this one behind them. Here's Keenum now on 2nd down. That'll be incomplete with 9 seconds now showing on the clock. The Vikings on 3rd down. They've converted 5 times in their many chances thus far. This will be 3rd and a mile.
Here we go now. Blue lining.
From the gun, here's Keenum. And that is incomplete, stopping the clock with 5 seconds to go.
Let's give some credit to the defensive guys on that play. Able to bat that one away. Sure looked like they were trying to hit the corner route.
Here's Ryan Quigley now, as he's on to punt for Minnesota. And he deserves a bronze leg as he gets this one away. Good footwork at the 30. Still shedding tackles. And he'll go out of bounds across the 35-yard line. And Charles, I think when the schedule comes out, all teams, no matter where they're predicted to finish, talk about protecting your home turf. They were able to do that here in this one.
Similar to a tennis match, right? Not letting them break your serve. That way you hold on to it. They got it done, and they feel very good about that victory.
So that'll just about do it for Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gauden. You've been watching the NFL on EA Sports. For more, log on to easports.com. The Eagles are winners here as we say so long.